My name is Sarah Fraher. I started flying 6 years ago, and I've been commercially flying for 3 years.
She's probably gonna be pissed off that we're late.
John Ponce is my boyfriend. We've been dating for 1 year. First time I saw him, he gave me a big smile, and I kind of blew him off because he was just a co-pilot, and I didn't think too much about him, but he was persistent, and we finally hit it off after many months. He's now out of Unicleat, and I fly out of St. Mary's. We get to see each other every couple days for about 5 minutes to switch off passengers and get a quick kiss in.
I hope you'll...
Yeah. John was 30 minutes late to meeting me, but luckily I was able to get my passengers into a warm terminal.
First snow of the year. She flew with me as a passenger one day, and it was all she could do from not touching the controls.
It's scary to let your boyfriend take the control of the plane.
Hold on. Please.
Bye. See you tomorrow, hopefully.
Yeah.
It's always nice to be able to meet up with her. We were lucky if we got to talk to each other on the radio at least one time during her shift. So now that she got moved up to St. Mary's and gets to run the schedule to meet me, it's pretty cool.
Center of gravity is CG. We have to keep our planes balanced with forward and aft weights, and it can be very difficult when you have passengers that are 300 pounds and they could walk up with a bag that weighs 5 pounds, and that's what you're supposed to put in the nose, and then you're supposed to put them in the back.
Weather's definitely moving in, gusting over 30. It's getting cold, and I think the snow is about to come down. Looks like the ceiling's definitely getting lower, so we're gonna fuel up, grab our passengers, and get the hell out of here before it gets, visibility goes down or something.
Cool.
Yep. And down we go.
That's my fault.
That's all right, go ahead. When I get in, it'll be all right. Slide that back. Try to get more of the weight forward in the plane. All right, welcome aboard, everybody. My name's Sarah.
As the busiest hub comes back into full swing, Sarah Fraher is on her way to pilot station to pick up a child in need of medical attention.
And pilot station should be fun. It's gusting up to 26 straight across, which makes it for a pretty interesting roller coaster.
Pilot station's runway is positioned perpendicular to the Yukon River and is known for its unpredictable crosswinds and downdrafts. Because of the high wind surrounding the delta, Sarah uses crabbing to land the plane safely.
On the last second, we're going to straighten it out. I'm going to kick it with my right rudder, give a lot of left aileron, and put down my left tire first. Get my flaps up as soon as possible, because that's going to reduce the lift and try to get us to sink down.
Waiting at pilot station is a mother and her severely dehydrated child. The only way to receive medical treatment is to be flown 90 miles to Bethel, home to the only hospital for more than 50 villages. With the plane at maximum capacity, Sarah has to combat strong winds with a heavy load.
Air traffic, air 96 Mike's taxiing out, back taxi runway 07 pilot station. With the winds coming straight across, you get a lot of updrafts and downdrafts that you have to be careful about.
Aero pilot Sarah Fraher is facing strong winds on the takeoff from pilot station. Having a plane filled to capacity isn't making it any easier. Strong downdrafts push Sarah's plane back to the ground. But ultimately, her skill as a pilot enables her to outmaneuver the challenging winds.
That's the pilot station. I'm not a super windy day. I'll drag you straight off. Yeah, I find sometimes the takeoffs are harder than the landings. I like to pretend like it's a horse, like I'm riding a horse. I'm like, yeah. It's bush Alaska. I mean, the weather is gnarly out here, and anybody's a fool to think that it's not dangerous flying out here.
Sarah completes the 90-mile flight to Bethel, home of the only hospital in the region. Her young, dehydrated passenger receives the medical attention she needs.
All right, right this way, guys.
400 miles east of pilot station lies Palma. New father and Unikalit native Yuri Ivanov is training for an upgrade into the 208 caravan.
Run through some emergency procedures, some landings, steep turns, stuff you could get familiar with the plane with.
If Yuri can prove himself to the Czech airman Ross Nixon, it means more money and more flight time with Aero Alaska.
Pretty tough day. It's blowing 34 knots out here, and that's enough for any pilot. And, you know, we're throwing him into the fire right away.
We'll go to Willow. We'll do some touch and goes. Got that?
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Yuri must show Ross that he's able to successfully execute a landing and a takeoff without stopping, known as a touch and go. This essential skill is used to test questionable surfaces and abort landings in emergency situations.
Okay, so you want to slow her down, right?
Yuri navigates severe turbulence under the watchful eye of Ross as he approaches for his first touch and go.
See if we can just touch down at the second light.
You know, it's a little windy out here, so it had little chops here and there, but all in all, it was turned out pretty good.
We'll just give them some more experience, and as we keep flying, we keep adding new things to the equation. So, you know, he's learning quite a bit here. So I think he'll just get better and better after today.